Hello and welcome to this edition of the Campus Check-In here on WGN News Now. I'm Larry Hawley. It's that time of year where conference football is at the top of everybody's mind, but basketball is starting to creep into the conversation, so we'll cover both sports today on the show. Let's go ahead and get right to the syllabus, though. As we take a look at the college football teams locally, the major ones, that is, we'll have two that are doing very well and two others that are struggling, but we will cover all four of those squads, including a major Illinois showdown with Minnesota in Champaign on Saturday. College basketball preseason picks continue to come in. There are also media days as well. We'll have more on that later in the show. Plus, we'll also talk to one of the most productive running backs in all of college football, and you can find him at North Central College. But first, we begin with the Illini, who got some major help last week from their backup kicker.
I had a great conversation with McManus before the field goals, and we just try to talk casual so we, you know, keep our mind off everything else, not get nervous, try to stay in that chill mindset.
Freshman kicker Fabrizio Pinton was forced into action when regular kicker Caleb Griffin was injured and hit three field goals in his first college game to give Illinois a 9-6 win over Iowa and improve their record to 5-1 on the season. But the challenges do not stop for the Illini if they hope to be a player in the Big Ten West title race. Minnesota, who many consider to be the front runner at the moment, comes to Champaign for an 11 a.m. kickoff on Saturday. The status of starting quarterback Tommy DeVito is still very much up in the air after his ankle injury last week. If he can't go, it's Art Sikowski who gets the start. Illinois' strong first half of the season has now earned the program something they have not had in 11 years. That is a national ranking. And when Brett Bielema found out how long that drought in the polls had been for the 24th-ranked Illini, he was a little bit taken aback.
Illinois is the last Power 5 team that hasn't been ranked since 2011. And I'm like, I stopped and I said, what did he say? And she said, we haven't been ranked since 2011. He's asking if we're going to get ranked. And I had no idea, none. Yesterday, I didn't even really think about it much after that. I thought we'd probably be another week. If we were able to have success this week, we might get ranked. But when that came through yesterday, I was literally just sat there for a moment, kind of digested it and thought about it. I thought it was a good thing. You know, I grew up and played for Coach Fry. And Coach Fry always said, partner, if you've done it, you ain't bragging. And that's why I showed it. It was one of the first graphics I showed our players, right? Because I know other people are going to talk about it, right? So it's a product of what they've built and what they've tried to accomplish, but it's definitely not our ending point. It's hopefully just a catalyst in our future.
On the opposite end of the spectrum are the Northwestern Wildcats, who are limping into their second bye week after losing five straight games. That includes a 42-7 crushing at the hands of Wisconsin last week in Evanston, as the Badgers gained 515 yards in their first game under interim head coach Jim Leonard. Now 1-5 on the season, the Wildcats will face Maryland next Saturday in College Park. Meanwhile, Notre Dame is finding their stride a bit after losing their first two games of the season as they picked up their biggest victory of the 2022 campaign to date last Saturday. The Irish continued their string of success in their Shamrock Series games with a 28-20 win over 16th-ranked BYU in Las Vegas. Michael Mayer was a star for the Irish as he had 11 receptions for 118 yards and two touchdowns, and in the process became the school's all-time leader in tight end receptions. Stanford is up next for Notre Dame under the lights in South Bend on Saturday at 6:30 p.m. Central Time. And while the Irish have built up a little momentum at the moment, head coach Marcus Freeman wants the team's focus to remain on fixing mistakes and getting better, just like it was after the first 2 weeks when the Irish lost.
That's what I challenge our coaches and I'll challenge our players today, is that same lens that we have after a Marshall, after Ohio State, we got to watch after BYU. And it's tough because when you feel a certain way after Marshall, it's easy to go and say, all right, I'm already angry, right? I don't like that. And we're going to challenge each other. Right now, everybody's like, oh, man, we felt good after yesterday. Not today, we moved on. But, you know, we feel good after a big win over a really good opponent. We have to ask those same critical questions. What happened here? Why is it happening? What do we got to do to fix it?
Meanwhile, Northern Illinois' struggles continue as they took their fifth straight loss last Saturday at home. The offenses took center stage, but it was Toledo who had the upper hand, winning it 52-32. The reigning Mid-American Conference champions travel to Eastern Michigan this week with an uphill battle even just to make a bowl. They'll need to win five of their last six games in order to qualify. Today's cheat sheet sees no changes for three of our locally ranked number one squads. North Central College football and College of DuPage football each got decisive wins last week to stay number one in their respective divisions. University of Chicago's men's soccer is the same. Northwestern women's soccer is up to fifth in the United Soccer Coaches poll as they continue to pursue a Big Ten championship. Let's also mention Lewis University women's volleyball team. They remain steady in the Division II top 25, coming in this week at number 22. Our crash course today concerns one of the teams we just mentioned, North Central College football. As a Division III power has been aided by one of the most productive running backs in all of college football. That's Lindenhurst native Ethan Greenfield, who has rushed for 670 yards and 11 touchdowns with an 8.2 per carry average for the number one ranked Cardinals this season. This comes after he led Division III in rushing during the 2019 and 2021 seasons. His 5,352 yards are the most in the history of the CCIW Conference, a mark he broke against rival Wheaton a few weeks ago. Greenfield also has 72 career touchdowns and has averaged 7.2 yards per carry. What's funny is that Ethan might not have even played running back at all in college if it weren't for a few decisions along the way.
First season of playing running back, my senior year of high school, I was mainly like a safety linebacker before that. And then when I came here, Coach Thorne asked me what position I wanted to play, and I told him wherever the team needs help, and ended up being at running back. And good thing he kept me there, because it ended up ending pretty well. The biggest thing that really helped me become successful my freshman year here was the older guys, the older running backs in my position group, and guys even my age. I mean, it was senior at the time, Donald Gallo, really took me under his wing, and then my teammate Terrence Hill as well, and really showed us the ropes of what it is to be a running back and helped us learn the offense and learn everything. And he's a huge reason to why I'm able to be who I am today and perform like how I do. And same with Terrence Hill. I mean, he's another fifth year senior and a running back like me, and he's pushed me along the way, and we helped each other really just bring each other up every year and enhance our level of play. My offensive line, without a doubt, I mean, those guys work so hard day in and day out, and they really are the focal point of our offense, why I'm able to do what I do and what our quarterback and our passing game is. It's just the offensive line put in so much work, and they take so much pride into being able to be dominant and create big running lanes and move people, and game in and game out, they are the biggest reason that we've had success. I'm very grateful. I mean, I would have, if you told me 5 years ago I'd be where I am right now with what I've done in the program, I'd have a little bit of a hard time believing that, just because I know sometimes you doubt yourself a little bit, but I really was, the best was pulled out of me by my teammates and my coaches, and I'm very glad that I was kept where I am to help the team and help us do what we've done. But I mean, it's been an amazing journey, and I'm glad it went this way.
Position switch certainly working for Ethan at North Central. They will look to go 6-0 against Milliken in Naperville on Saturday. We've now reached the extra credit portion of the show, and for that we feature Big Ten Media Days and a bit of a change for 2022. Usually held in Chicago or Indianapolis, this year's Media Days were in Minneapolis at the Target Center. Illinois and Northwestern's men's and women's basketball made their way up north to talk about their teams ahead of the start of the season in a couple of weeks. There's a lot of chatter about Illinois basketball, since they are the reigning conference regular season champions. So what challenge does forward Coleman Hawkins believe the Illini will present in their title defense? Well, here's what he told to the media.
It's more positionless and a lot less structure. I think a lot more stuff is more randomized than what we had in the past couple years. And a little less predictable as well. So I think we have some great pieces that can be all over the place, and it's not really 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4-man does this, 5-man does that, 1 does this, you know, it's kind of just random.
Loyola's first Atlantic 10 Media Day is Thursday, but their projections for the upcoming season are already out. Drew Valentine's team has been picked fourth in their first season in the conference. Guard Braden Norris was a third-team preseason pick. Loyola, of course, making a little history this year as they head to the Atlantic 10 after so many years in the Missouri Valley Conference, including a championship to finish things out in the tournament in St. Louis. We'll have more coverage of basketball as it continues to get a little closer. Also watching the football teams, especially Illinois, as they right now look like they're on the course for a historic year in Champaign, ranked for the first time since 2011. Well, that will do it for this edition of the Campus Check-In. For up-to-date college news, please go to the sports page at WGNTV.com or the WGN News Now page if you'd like to see previous episodes of Campus Check-In, where we not only feature the big schools, but also some smaller schools who are doing big things here in 2022. But for now, I'm Larry Hawley, and have a wonderful day.